the common good and inspiring others. The annual Alumni Award acknowledges and celebrates these achievements by our outstanding alumni in their professional field or community services activities, service activities that should have been. Aidan Barron completed a Bachelor of Paramedic Practice at the University of Tasmania. He enrolled at CQUniversity, undertaking a Bachelor of Science honours whilst working as a paramedic. He continued his postgraduate studies at CQUniversity as one of the first cohort to complete the graduate certificate in clinical ultrasound with a specialization in emergency medicine point of care ultrasound. During this time, he co-authored a highly influential paper with Dr. Ruth in London as a visiting researcher and lecturer at Kingston University and St. George's University. Aidan went on to become the youngest ever member appointed to the editorial board of the Journal of Paramedic Practice and the youngest reviewer for leading journals such as the Resuscitation, Emergency Medicine Journal, and the Australian Journal of Ultrasound in Medicine. In 2021, he was appointed as the coordinator for clinical policy and strategy with St. John Ambulance New South Wales and established a volunteer clinical advice line for over 3,000 first aiders and health professionals around New South Wales. This advice line has since been instrumental in providing better care for patients in floods, bushfires, and the ongoing COVID pandemic. As of 2022, Aidan has delivered more than 50 invited lectures in 11 countries, is in his final 2 years of a medical degree at the University of Notre Dame, Sydney, and is the clinical lead of a locally based charity promoting community first aid and ethno-culturally congruent emergency medical care. Aidan has demonstrated significant and ongoing leadership in the space of emergency medicine and paramedicine through research, along with significant peer and advisory work. He has earned a national and international reputation in paramedic circles as being a keen advocate of evidence-based practice and equitable and non-discriminatory healthcare practice. To receive an Industry Excellence Award, please congratulate Mr. Aidan Barron. Doff to the Chancellor. Chancellor, that concludes the presentation of Alumni Award. I now invite Mr. Aidan Barron to deliver the occasional address.
Dear Chancellor, Vice Chancellor, members of the professoriate, faculty, colleagues, friends, family, and of course, graduates. I'd like to start by acknowledging that today we're standing on the traditional lands of the Gadigal, of the mighty Eora Nation. Gadi means grass tree, and so these are the lands of the people of the grass tree. I'd like to pay my respects to the custodians of this land, past, present, and emerging, and I'd like to thank them for their ongoing custodianship. I'd also like to acknowledge all First Nations people here today. And finally, I'd like to thank the university very dearly for this very, very large honour, and I'm incredibly grateful. Thank you so much for your ongoing support. I thought I'd share a few stories with you from my travels. I've had the privilege of working and volunteering in a number of interesting and wonderful places around the world, most of which have been quite resource constrained and remote. A number of years ago, I was in a small village called Bauni on the banks of the Chisang River in Nepal, in the Eastern Terai Plains. We're quite lucky as a university to have a wonderful relationship with the Nepalese community, and I really do look forward to that increasing and growing. And for those of you who haven't had the privilege and pleasure of going to Nepal, I seriously commend it. It's a beautiful country. So I'm in this gorgeous village. It's about 3 hours away from Biratnagar, about 14 hours from Kathmandu, and I'd been invited there to do some health promotion activities, specifically around pregnant mums and babies, using ultrasound to screen for something called placenta previa. And for those of you who don't know, placenta previa is essentially when the sac, which gives blood and oxygen to the baby and connects the mum and the baby together, is very low down in the womb. And so when the mum goes into labor, that sac can tear, and so blood and oxygen doesn't get to the baby, and the mum can also bleed out. And so unfortunately, both mum and baby can die. It's an incredible problem, bleeding in pregnancy, in most remote places around the world. And so I was there specifically to take an ultrasound machine to this clinic and to teach Alka and Yamuna, the two incredible healthcare workers there, how to screen for placenta previa using basic ultrasound. It's a very easy test. It takes 1 or 2 minutes. And so I was very excited, and I spent weeks and weeks preparing and creating special sheets and checklists and guidelines, and I had these forms ready, and I get there, and it's the first morning, and I'm halfway through a scan, and I thought, you know, I'm there to do placenta previa, but while I'm there, wouldn't it be great if we could do even more checks, you know, do a full pregnancy scan? And I'm there, and I'm scanning the first beautiful mom and her baby, and the power cuts out. The ultrasound machine only had about half an hour of battery on it, and there are another 4 women waiting for their scans. And unfortunately, the few months I was there, the power was cutting in and cutting out constantly. And so I had to take stock and step back and go, okay, what's the key here? What do we really need to get done? The key thing to get done was to scan for placenta previa with ultrasound, and that only took a few minutes. And everything else we could do without ultrasound. And so I said, stuff it. Get rid of all the complex checks and forms and checklists. Just do what matters. What's going to save a life? What's going to help that patient in front of us? And so what I would say to you is, when we're tasked with a project or a goal or an objective, when you start a new project, when you join a new business, when you're working with a new team, or you're delivering a new training package, or you're working with a new client, it's very easy to get bogged down in technicalities. It's so easy to get, you know, to get discouraged and find yourself stuck in details and legalities and policy and procedure. It is crucial that you take a step back and focus on the key objective, your unique selling point, the key deliverable. What are you there to deliver? And focus on doing that with excellence. And if you just focus on that with excellence and delivering that, all the details will sort themselves out, because that's what you're there for. So focus on what matters and don't get distracted by details. More recently, I was speaking to a close friend and mentee of mine. It was on Zoom. It was about, I think, 12:30 at night. I'm a bit of a night owl. That's when I wrote most of my thesis, and my honors supervisor, Professor Anne Quinton, is here on stage, which is very special for me. And so I was on Zoom, and it was 12:30, and I was quite tired, and I was speaking to my friend who was a new nurse in Papua New Guinea, and he had gone over there to do 2 things. He was there to set up a field hospital for COVID and also to help run an ambulance officers training course for members of the community. And we were speaking, and he was really frustrated. He was saying, Aidan, you know, I'm spending all this time creating these policies and checklists to help new nurses at the bedside recognize when a patient with COVID is getting more sick. Most of them are supposed to get better, but sometimes they start to get more sick and more breathless, and they're finding it hard to breathe, and they need to escalate it, get a doctor involved, get another nurse involved, start some more medication, turn the oxygen up. He's going, Aidan, I spent all week trying to get my new nurses to focus on these new checklists, and I go away for a week to train up ambulance officers, and I come back, and everyone's defaulted to their normal practice. And so we had a chat. As humans, we all want to leave a legacy. We all want to feel that we're making a positive contribution. And it's very easy to feel that our contribution is a thing, is a project. We want to be able to say, I did that, I built that program, I designed that software, I created that policy, I engineered that structure, because it makes us feel that something of us is going to outlast us, that we have a legacy that will live on in the world. My friend and I spoke at length, and I talked to him about how to have the biggest impact in the 1 year that he was there in Port Moresby. And the lesson I'm going to share with you is the lesson that I've learned the hard way, and now I shared with him as well. It's invest in people and not things. He shifted from investing his energy into implementing escalation policies instead to spending as much time at the bedside with his nurses as possible, giving them additional skills, which they can then take on to thousands more patients and they can then teach other nurses with. And that's going to have a far bigger impact for thousands more people than any policy or implementation procedure ever will. Whenever we come into a new team or we join a new group, we like to think that we have the solution to other people's problems. We think that there's a clear solution ahead. But the truth is that oftentimes there are nuanced, contextual, and cultural factors in those groups, in those dynamics that we can't appreciate. We can't come into new organizations, teams, businesses, units, and start telling people how to fix their problems, because our solutions will almost always lack contextual nuance. Instead, we should aim to give people the tools to solve their own problems by investing in them. Invest energy into raising people up. Support them, mentor them, educate, foster. The team or the community with the problem are those who are best placed to solve that problem. So invest in those people, because our lasting legacies, when we're all retired and done and looking back on our lives, will not be the things we did, but the people we invested in. Focus on what matters and invest in others. That is your legacy. And with that, I'd like to wish a hearty congratulations to all our graduates today. Have a wonderful day, and congratulations all. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Barron, and we look forward to following your career, Aidan, and being able to call you Dr. Barron in a few years' time. I now call upon Professor Nick Klomp to present the graduates.
Will all graduates please stand? Chancellor, I certify to you and to Council these graduates standing before you today have fulfilled the requirements prescribed by the university, and I ask that you present them with their respective awards.
Thank you, Vice Chancellor. In the name of the Governing Council of Central Queensland University and by my authority as Chancellor, I am pleased to present you all with your awards. Can everyone please honour our newest graduates?
Will all graduates please be seated?
Chancellor, I call upon Dr. Anne Sardese, Senior Lecturer in Accounting, to present the graduates.
Chancellor, I present to you the first half of graduates from Vocational Education and Training, undergraduate and postgraduate courses. Brittany Kim Miles, Diploma of Work Health and Safety. James Bruce Barnett, Bachelor of Accident Forensics. Melissa J. Walpole, Bachelor of Accident Forensics with Distinction. Ashley Kate Baker, Bachelor of Accounting. The student is wearing a cultural sash. Osman Ali Buyan, Bachelor of Accounting. Rishal Ann Emperado. Ayushma Pandit. Sritika Risal. Sarah Jane Zamora, Bachelor of Accounting Management. Jared Ryan Smith, Bachelor of Business, Human Resource Management and Marketing. Bachelor of Business Management, Sanya Chauhan. Thank you. Stephanus Danny Linendiaya. John Paul Oberai. Bachelor of Business Management and Accounting with Distinction, Aldrix May Condino. Bachelor of Digital Media, Ali El Rais. Bachelor of Education, Early Childhood, Chloe Jane Thompson. Bachelor of Exercise and Sports Sciences, Timothy Ivermay. Bachelor of Health and Rehabilitation Science, Tin Yan Yip. Bachelor of Health Science Imaging, Chana Harkam. Bachelor of Information Technology, Application Development, Harshika Bale. Sitara Silva. Bachelor of Information Technology, Business Analysis, Ritu Bechtel. Ujan Maharjan. Bachelor of Information Technology Business Analysis, Munaswamy Buneshwari Aditya. Santosh James Tamang. Bachelor of Information Technology Network Security, Vikramachige Gunanvardhana. Bachelor of Laws, Caroline Boutros. Dominic Carroll. Timothy Carroll. Charalambia Ivipidu. Michael de Graaf Forsen. Jenna Melissa Hazuri. Grace Hewitt. Emilia Melgate. Aya Nasser. Kate Elizabeth Rue. Chao Ting Yung. Bachelor of Medical Science, Biotechnology, Despina Mikhail. Bachelor of Nursing, Melanie May Blacktop. The student is wearing a cultural sash, Catherine Ann Bruce. Pearl Mahalia Dillian. Kathleen Ann Ferndale. Erin Paige Hagedorn. Heidi Lee Haley. The student is wearing a cultural sash, Michelle Cherie Parkin. Catherine Marie Smart. Rachel Claire Thompson. Bachelor of Nursing with Distinction, Donna Gay McCartney. Jessie Lee Nicole Menon. Bachelor of Property, Reena Prasad. Bachelor of Psychological Science, Jordan D. Watson. Bachelor of Science, Chiropractic with Distinction, Christopher Lamachia. Bachelor of Science, Psychology with Distinction, Kelly Ann Matheson. Bachelor of Construction Management Honors, Thomas Peter Adams. Mitchell Ian Hayes. Bachelor of Engineering Honours Civil, Sarah Renee Wilcott. Bachelor of Physiotherapy Honours, Chinhui Niu. Bachelor of Podiatry Practice Honours, Meena Awad. Hilary Child. Michael Melek. Madeline Parker. Roberto Jose Perez. Lenore Smith. Bachelor of Psychological Science Honours, Jessica Elise Davis. Graduate Certificate in Asset and Maintenance Management, Michael Allen Boyle. Graduate Certificate in Asset and Maintenance Management with Distinction, Joshua Michael Doyle. Graduate Certificate in Management, Lena Abdul-Jabbar. Graduate Certificate in Positive Psychology with Distinction, Damien Pigott. Graduate Certificate in Research with Distinction, Gok Te Hahu. Graduate Diploma of Asset and Maintenance Management with Distinction, Leonard Mai Francis. Bachelor of Echocardiography and Cardiac Physiology, Graduate Diploma of Echocardiography, Anna Simone Abdul Malik. Varsha Biju. Miriam Botros. Mikhaila Kalogiros. Manpreet Kaur Sandal. Bachelor of Medical Sonography, Graduate Diploma of Medical Sonography, Mark Bishai. Simone Best. Lana Maud. Lydia Nada. Matthew Seffin. Yasmin Sindian. Katrina Wong. Bachelor of Medical Sonography, Graduate Diploma of Medical Sonography with Distinction, Anne Diakos. Vinnie Flora. Kira Elizabeth Moriarty. Master of Applied Positive Psychology, Scott Michael Bidmain. Master of Business Administration, Ernest Takavarasha. Master of Business Administration Leadership, Melissa Narell Olson. Master of Business Administration Leadership with Distinction, Mohammed Hassan Zaid. Master of Business Management, Hospital and Health Services Management, Juvian K. Paredes. Master of Business Management, Hospital and Health Services Management with Distinction, Sheila Marie Rector. Master of Business Management, International Business, Manili Arakan. Sevelma Balor Bater. Iron Racy Lok. Malveya Jitender. Orafan Sakulvikai. Master of Clinical Chiropractic with Distinction, Ben Taylor. Master of Clinical Psychology with Distinction, Neeta Thambi. Master of Financial Planning with Distinction, Kwok Hong To. Master of Human Resource Management, Patel Shailesh Kumar. Krishna Sen. Anand Tekchandani. Master of Information Systems, Sheikh Hamid. Ashish Krishna Adepu. Ahmed Azim Anwar. Hetige Sandali Madhubani Pereira. Utsav Koirala. Swati Kumari. Sai Kiran Reddy Mula. Sushila Rai. Pramila Shrestha. Master of Information Systems with Distinction, Rohan Roy Augustine. Nipuni Vindula Gunatilaka. Apeksha Gurung. Srinath Kaniyappan. Akriti Shahi. Master of Information Technology, Mobile Application Development, Jose Manuel Perez Dominguez. Nagula Vancha Dilip Kumar. Vimesh Uprati. Master of Information Technology, Mobile Application Development with Distinction, Pavitra Madhuvanti Atukorala Donna. Mandalwala Archige Asanka Chandrakumara Mandalwala. Chancellor, that concludes the presentation of the first half of graduates.
Before we continue, I think Anne Sardesay deserves a round of applause for absolutely nailing those names. All right. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm pleased to present a musical performance by Miss Laura Garrick. Miss Garrick graduated from CQ University's Bachelor of Musical Theatre course in 2013. Her career highlights include touring Singapore and the Philippines, hosting the Peppa Pig show, performing the role of Eponine in Les Miserables, singing the Australian and American national anthems at the Matilda versus USA soccer game, and most recently performing in Mamma Mia, the musical. Please join me in welcoming Laura to the stage.
Before you open up the dirty window, let the sun illuminate the words that you could not find, reaching for something in the distance, so close you can almost taste it. Release your inhibitions, feel that rain on your skin. No one else can feel it for you, only you can let it in. No one else, no one else can speak the words on your lips. Drench yourself in words unspoken, open. Today is where your book begins. The rest is still unwritten. Oh, 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 oh. I break tradition. Sometimes my tries, they're outside the lines. We've been conditioned to not make mistakes, but I can't live that way. Staring at that blank page before you, open up the dirty window, let the sun illuminate the words that you could not find, reaching for something in the distance, so close you can almost taste it. Release your inhibitions, feel that rain on your unspoken. Live your life with arms wide open. Today is where you feel that rain on your skin. No one else can feel it for you, only you can let it in. No one else, no one else can speak the words on your lips. Drench yourself in words unspoken. Live your life with arms wide open. Today is where your book begins. The rest is still unwritten.
Thank you.
Thank you very much, Ms. Garrick. I now invite the Deputy Chancellor, Dr. Robin Minchinton, to receive the second half of graduates and present them with their awards. I call upon Dr. Sardese to continue the presentation of the graduates. And I think it might have been Michael and his friends over there, family members who I think had the longest chair. We see you. So that is the standard that the second half has to now try to beat. So without any further ado, over to Anne and Robin.
Deputy Chancellor, I now present the second half of graduates from postgraduate courses. Master of Information Technology, Networks and Information Security, Mir Murtuza Ali. Sri Sailam Reddy Anugu. Sujan Kumar Ariel. Varsha Chowdhury Bachina. Jasmina Dahal. Mohammad Farhan Dar. Ruben Gupta. Maruf bin Habib. Yasasmini Hanumanula. Dimple Bipin Chandra Joshi. Ashim Karki. Komal Preet Kaur. Sunil Maske. Manisha Mogula. Shoaib Mohiuddin Mohammed. Mohammed Mohiuddin. Temujin Mukbold. Sivakumar Naka. Nisarg Nitin Kumar Parikh. Sejal Bharat Kumar Patel. Bibek Pokharel. Navaraj Pudel. Syed Abdul Rahman. Borson Sarkar. Jayant Talapalli. Sai Pradeep Tota. Vivid Wagle. Vishal Ban. Mahesh Tapa Magar. Aman Maharjan. Rajipan Rajadurai. Ankit Shrestha. Govinda Lohani. Shailina Maharjan. Anita Maharjan. Eragam Madhuri Manimala. Utsav Shrestha. Maruf Ahmad Siddiq. Tanzila Tehera. Andol Venkatesh. Dipendra Bhandari. Akesh Kunwar. Jayasekara Lakshika. Revat Poon. Treetin Bo. Mohammed Ubaidullah Khan. Vishal Maini. Nagula Gautam Raj. This is a very easy name, Shubham. Manpreet Singh. Manoni Darsan Renuga Tandapani. Aditya Reddy Turpu. Master of Medical Ultrasound with Distinction, Amy Marie Clark. Master of Professional Accounting, Ashma Timalsina Adhikari. Sudeep Bajracharya. Barsha Sanchauri Vishwakarma. Meghna Jayesh Butch. Bernice Riza Dias.
Hello.
I remember she's my student. Thilini Vasana Dissanayaka. Seth Segbayer, Eldiv Ocher. Herath Mudian Selage Ashan Herath. Sharmila Islam. Pratiksha Jha. Ramita Karki. Gurpa Vandeep Kaur. Mohammed Umar Khalid. Tanjuma Khanam. Subhadi Bujal Lakshmi. Dilshi Dissanayaka Mabarana. Shraddha Pradhan. Alicia Shakya. Rojina Shakya. Sandhya Shrestha. Another Sandhya Shrestha. Sabia Shrestha. Rohini Taujale. Ram Babu Taladar. Master of Professional Accounting with Distinction, Katrina Dilos Santos. Master of Project Management, Pavani Bukhia. Mustafa Dusku. Aldar Ganbatar. Timit Kam Kalimag. Yeah. Asad Alam Khan. Palla Manisha. Gansuk Purabjao. Moiz Syed. Master of Project Management with Distinction, Nimika Idunul Patirana. Master of Public Health, Krishna Singh Airi. Neeta. Salina Baiju. Leela Bajgain. Pradeep Bhandari. Rabina Basima Shahukal. Shanti Bhattarai. Bikram Dangol. Anupreet Dhillon. Karishma Dhimal. Kalpana Chaturika Kumari Gajanayaka. Pramila Kavas. Rizwan Ali Masood. Shiv Ranjan Kumar Mishra. Lakshmi Pariyar. Yashasvi Pashikanti. Krishna Prajapati. Shrishti Rejmi. Vandana Sa. Master of Public Health with Distinction, Daisy Besselio. Sachini Vijayakaluthalika. Deputy Chancellor, that concludes the presentation of graduates from vocational education and training, undergraduate and postgraduate courses.
Thank you, Dr. Sardase. Chancellor, I now invite the Vice Chancellor and President, Professor Nick Klomp, to present the doctoral graduates.
Chancellor, I have the honour to present to you the following doctoral graduates. These candidates have undertaken a program of supervised research and study that has made a significant original contribution to knowledge. This qualification is a highly regarded achievement where the candidate has demonstrated highly specialised knowledge through their dissertation. Doctoral programs may be undertaken in many disciplines, but only high calibre graduates who have demonstrated academic merit may obtain entry to this award. Research is an integral part of CQUniversity Australia's purpose. We have a strong commitment to the conduct of cutting-edge research in new areas which challenge the boundaries of the traditional disciplines to provide distinctive research solutions with regional, national, and international benefit. Chancellor, ladies and gentlemen, I present Emily Henkel for the degree of Doctor of Philosophy. Emily's... Emily's getting two applauses now. Emily's thesis title is The Impact of Storage Conditions on the Stability of Clinical and Experimental Pharmaceuticals. This research utilised analytical techniques to explore how the storage conditions of pharmaceuticals can affect their stability. These findings demonstrate the importance of controlling the storage environment of pharmaceuticals so their full potency is retained long term. Supervised by Principal Supervisor Dr. Andrew Finning and Associate Supervisor Dr. Rebecca Vella, I present Dr. Emily Henkel. Chancellor, I present Fazana Raymond Safi for the degree of Doctor of Philosophy. Fazana's thesis title is The Influence of Human Resource Management Practices on Organisational and National Turnover Intentions, a study of Pakistani university academics. This PhD thesis considered the resource-based theory, human capital theory, and social exchange theory, and found that both organisational and national turnover intentions of academics were rarely examined. This study employed a quantitative research method and found that strategic human resource management practices generate academics' organisational and national turnover intentions. Supervised by Principal Supervisor Dr. Parvez Sultan, Associate Supervisors Professor Quamrul Alam and Dr. Muhammad Abu Saleh, I present Dr. Fazana Raymond Safi. Chancellor, I present Prabhu Singh for the degree of Doctor of Philosophy. Prabhu's thesis title is A Contribution to Communication Management in Private Unmanned Aerial Vehicle Networks. This research provides solutions for various issues relating to communication management in private unmanned aerial vehicle networks that have been designed for commercial uses such as agriculture, livestock farming, and natural disaster situations. Supervised by Principal Supervisor Dr. Rowan De Silva and Associate Supervisor Dr. Indra Sia, I present
Dr. Prabhu Singh. I present Michael Topper for the degree of Doctor of Professional Studies. Michael's thesis title is The Perceptions and Attitudes of Australian Financial Advisors Regarding Factors That Influence Client Referrals from Other Financial Service Professionals. This research explored professional referrals in the Australian financial services industry. A mixed method approach was adopted to test a proposed referral networking model. Results showed that financial advisors who gained regular referrals from other professionals undertook more of the activities set out in the model and gained larger business benefits. Supervised by Principal Supervisor Dr. Tassadak Iman and Associate Supervisors Dr. Julie Knutson and Professor of Practice Adam Steen, I present Dr. Michael Topper. And finally, Chancellor, I present Dr. Richard Townsend for the degree of Doctor of Philosophy. Richard's thesis title is Rush to Judgment, Aestheticising the Double Frame of the Postmodern Performative Narrative. Through his original novella and exegesis, the candidate examined the potential of Professor Raoul Eshelman's theory of performatism to take crime writing beyond postmodern, post-structural, aesthetic and critical approaches. The candidate employed a new method for testing the functional feasibility of an alternative perspective in creative writing and critical theory. Supervised by Principal Supervisor Dr. Nicole Anay and Associate Supervisor Dr. Anne-Marie Priest. Chancellor, I present Dr. Richard Townsend. Chancellor, that concludes the presentation of doctoral graduates.
Thank you, Professor Klomp. I invite the Deputy Chancellor, Dr. Robin Minchinton, to present the honorary award recipients.
Chancellor, I present Professor Ross Chapman to be appointed as Emeritus Professor of the University. Since 1985, Professor Chapman has taught and researched in the important fields of quality management and continuous improvement, IT and operations management. He worked for 8 years in the private sector, including ICI and North Broken Hill Holdings, while also researching for his PhD. He won and managed large research grants and consultancies, many with international partners. Professor Chapman is a fellow of the Australian Institute of Company Directors, has been a non-executive director on the board of several not-for-profit organisations, and is a life fellow of the Academy of Management in Australia and New Zealand. As well, Professor Chapman has supervised 16 PhD completions to date as a principal supervisor and still supervises international and domestic research higher degree students. These are all wonderful contributions to an important body of work. Professor Chapman's extensive role in shaping quality management and continuous improvement globally is worthy of our recognition. And on this basis, CQ University confers on Ross Chapman the degree of Emeritus Professor. Chancellor, I present Mr. Robert Whittaker, AM, to be conferred with the honorary degree of Doctor of Construction Management. In the 1980s, while completing a Bachelor of Applied Science Building at UTS and working for building contractors, Robert saw the need for more transparency in the attainment of professional standards in the building industry. Robert's leadership positions in the Australian Institute of Building enabled him to promote higher professional standards in the industry. He became deeply involved in the formulation of legislation and regulations for the construction industry. His contribution was recognised by the 2002 Consumer Protection Award from New South Wales Fair Trading. Robert has served or still serves as director, chair, and member of numerous national and state boards, colleges, committees, registers, and judging panels. He remains committed to improving standards and enhancing the reputation of the building profession with building regulators, industry and academia alike. At a number of universities, including our own, Mr. Whittaker is a member of industry advisory committees for building and construction management courses. He ensures that CQ University's construction management programs are nationally licensed and industry accredited. He has still found time to further share his practical wisdom by authoring and co-authoring 3 books and over 90 refereed journal and conference papers. Mr. Whittaker was admitted as a member of the Order of Australia in 2014 for his significant contributions. He was also elected a Fellow of the Royal Society of New South Wales, the first builder in its 200-year history and first in the Commonwealth Royal Society's history since Thomas Telford in the 18th century. Robert's significant contribution to developing the building and construction industry in both the professional and education sector throughout his incredible career demonstrates that Robert is a person CQ University is very proud to acknowledge. On this basis, the university confers on Robert Whittaker, AM, the degree of Honorary Doctor of Construction Management. Chancellor, that concludes the presentation of the honorary awards.
Chancellor, I'm now pleased to present the recipient of the Associate Vice President's New South Wales Region Medal. This medal recognises a student who has demonstrated a combination of the following: a strong commitment to their studies, the ability to respond to challenges, a capacity to act as a mentor to other students, and an outstanding potential for significant leadership in their future careers, clear commitment to the value of cultural diversity and creative talent and enterprise. To receive the Associate Vice President's New South Wales Region Medal, I'm pleased to present Master of Information Technology, Networks and Information Security, and Graduate Certificate in Project Management graduate, Mr. Ruben Gupta. Thank you, Chancellor. I now call upon Ms. Lenore Smith to deliver the response by the graduate's representative.
Chancellor, Vice-Chancellor, honoured guests, staff of the university and fellow students, good afternoon. On behalf of my fellow graduates, I would like to present our guest speaker, Aidan Barron, with this special gift as a token of our appreciation. Oh, wow. I truly can't believe we're all finally here today. Isn't it great? As graduates, today is the day we all gather together to celebrate our achievements, our accomplishments, and our successes. So congratulations to you all. So for many of us, it's been over a year and a half since we finished our exams and started our new careers and lives. And I have to be honest and say, as time passed and my life moved on, I actually wondered if a graduation ceremony was even necessary. But then I came across the work of the anthropologist Dimitris Zagalatis. He observed that the most important moments of our lives are marked by ceremonies and rituals, and that in times of uncertainty, like these, they help impose order on the chaos of everyday life. Rituals and ceremonies forge a sense of belonging and common identity. So, by acting as one, we feel as one. So now I know why I need to be here today, why we all need to be here today, and why it feels so good. When COVID first struck and we went into lockdown, I felt the stress and anxiety of my final year only intensify. And I seriously wondered how we would ever finish our degrees. Sure, we were able to move to online teaching and Zoom, but so much of our final year also required face-to-face clinical practice with actual patients. So I was constantly amazed at the resilience of the teaching body to adapt to the challenges we faced. On behalf of the Sydney graduates, I would like to extend my deep gratitude and appreciation to the CQU staff, especially our teachers and lecturers. I have nothing but praise for their perpetual resilience and ability to adapt, and their ongoing encouragement to help us do the same. Now, since COVID has become part of our lives, we've all heard the word resilience used regularly. And I think it's important to understand that having resilience doesn't mean you won't experience stress or emotional upheaval. Resilience is how you are affected by and adapt to adversity, change, and loss. It requires flexibility, adaptability, and perseverance. You would all not be here now if you didn't have these qualities. So, congratulations to you all on your resilience. Now, while a degree from university can provide you with an entree card into a new career, it also teaches other valuable life skills, such as the ability to think creatively, solve problems, and innovate. But I believe one of the most essential skills it teaches is critical thinking. This skill is particularly important at a time in history when we're witnessing a rise in disinformation, conspiracy theories, and the so-called fake news. Critical thinking requires you to be an active learner rather than a passive recipient of information. Critical thinking requires you to be aware of your personal beliefs and biases and to consider different perspectives. It requires you to analyse, synthesise, and evaluate information and then provide good quality evidence and structured reasoning to validate your decisions. Indeed, I confess that many of my own views were tested with the development and application of this skill. Well, no doubt everyone graduating today will agree we're all here due to the love, patience, and endless support of our family and friends. On a personal note, I want to thank my incredible husband, Warren. I'm grateful every day that you believed in me. To my mum and dad, who always believed I was capable of much more. To my sister Linda, my best friend, my cheerleader, and my always available editor. And to my Sydney classmates, go Pods! But especially my good friend Hillary, who provided constant encouragement and a shoulder to cry on. Thank you. I graduated from high school in 1976. Most of you weren't even born then. I'm guessing most of your parents weren't even born then. I started my work life as an actor and I had a great career. And then I moved into another career altogether in my late 40s. I was 58 when I enrolled at CQUniversity and I finished my degree 4 years later when many of my friends were considering retirement. So, if there's one piece of advice I'd like to leave you all with today, it's this. Don't feel like you have to decide on the one thing you want to do with the rest of your life. Life is long. Well, hopefully. So, be a lifelong learner. Learn as much as you can, about as much as you can. You never know where it will take you.
Thank you, Ms. Smith. I now ask the Chancellor to deliver the charge to graduates.
Thanks, Shahan. If there's someone in control of the lights, can we turn the house lights up more so we can see our graduates? Is that possible? Maybe not.
Doesn't look like it. Okay.
Can all our graduates please stand? Oh, there we go. Excellent. Thank you. A lot of what we do at university graduations is part of centuries-long traditions. The regalia that we wear, the academic procession which started this proceedings today, the gathering of this congregation are all part of those traditions. As newly confirmed graduates of CQ University, it is at this stage we do the turning of the tassel ceremony. So please now move your tassel from the right-hand side of your mortarboard or bonnet to the left-hand side. Fantastic. Doesn't that feel different? That change symbolises your move from graduate to graduate. As Chancellor, I charge you as graduates and the newest members of the CQ University alumni to maintain a commitment to lifelong learning, to challenge yourself at all times, to commit to the university values of engagement, can-do, openness, leadership and inclusiveness, to contribute to your chosen profession, and by the application of your qualifications and abilities, support, nurture, and positively contribute to the communities of which you are part. May your awards bring honour to your university, to your chosen profession, but most importantly, to yourself. Congratulations, everybody. You may be seated.
You can now turn down the lights and just have a spotlight on me. Yeah. ladies and gentlemen, that concludes the ceremony. On behalf of the Chancellor and staff from CQ University Sydney, I would like to thank you all for attending. One of the things that we've always said at the Sydney campus is we have this saying called Umbutu, which is in Zulu, I am because we are. And today I'd like to thank you for making us successful because you today have been successful in completing your journey. So thank you very much for that. I ask you to please now stand while the official party retires and applaud our graduates as they walk through. Thank you very much. Thank you.